Hi, and welcome back to the C. Havoy Engineering YouTube channel. The nucleus of radioactive material emits three different types of radiation rays called alpha, beta, and gamma. Because of the different electrical charge properties of alpha, beta, and gamma radiation rays, they can be separated by directing a beam from a radioactive source through a magnetic field. Particles from a radioactive atom's nucleus are carried by alpha rays. These particles are made up of two protons and two neutrons. They are basically positively charged helium atoms, with electrons removed. The magnet causes these particles in the alpha ray to be bent in one direction. Beta rays are a stream of negatively charged electrons. After passing through the magnet, they bend in the opposite direction of the alpha ray. Because the electrons of the beta ray have less mass than the protons and neutrons in the alpha ray, the beta ray undergoes a more pronounced bend. Gamma rays are pure energy because they have no mass or charge and are not affected by magnetic fields. The ability of these three kinds of radiation to penetrate different materials is affected by their unique characteristics. A layer of paper stops an alpha particle. The beta particle easily passes through paper but is stopped by aluminium. A gamma ray is not stopped by the paper or aluminium, but its progress can be stopped by lead. The degree to which each of these three forms of radiation penetrate human tissue is the basis for limiting a person's exposure to radioactive material. In terms of the impact of radiation on the human body, alpha particles are generally stopped by the outer layer of skin and pose no real harm to underlying tissue. Beta particles, however, are not stopped by the protective layer of skin and can damage deep sensitive tissue. Gamma rays likewise can penetrate deep into the body and cause harm. This is why it is necessary to wear specialized protective gear when working with radioactive materials. When a neutron is fired at high speed into an atom of uranium, it will split the atom in a process called fission. The stability of the nucleus of an atom is maintained by the balance between the repulsive electrical force among protons and the attractive nuclear forces, holding the nucleus together. This equilibrium is unstable in uranium, so when a fast-moving neutron collides with the uranium-235 nucleus, it is stretched into an elongated shape. This elongated shape upsets the balance in favor of repulsive forces, causing the uranium-235 atom to split into fragments of krypton and barium. Three neutrons are also generated from this powerful release of energy. Three forcefully ejected neutrons can each strike an atom of uranium, resulting in the case of an atomic bomb, a catastrophic chain reaction. The nuclear fission process is also the source of energy used to operate nuclear power plants. In a controlled environment, the tremendous heat generated by splitting uranium-235 is used to produce steam that drives turbines to generate electricity. You can see how a nuclear power plant works in one of my previous videos. The link to it is above. I hope this video has helped you get the basic knowledge about radiation rays. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share this video, and watch the rest of my videos from my YouTube channel. Please also consider to support me on Patreon. Thanks very much, and see you on the next video.